The seventh point is related to the efficient resourcing and effective governance through the school complex and clusters. Now the different schools are there and having a less number of students, but in this NAP 2020, they are focusing on the school complexes or the clusters. So number of schools are combined together or merged together. That is called as school complex or cluster. So why these school complexes are there and how to go for this efficient resourcing or efficient governance through all these school complexes. So to ensure that adequate number of counselors, so counselors can be shared. So different counselor for a different school is not feasible nowadays. And that is why one counselor can be feasible for the school complex. So that school counselor or that trainer can share their views, can give their time to number of students, to number of teachers also, if it is added. Sometimes some subjects like art, music, science, sports, language, and vocational subjects are also there. So for these subjects, if a single or two subject teachers are there for that school complex, then it is sufficient. But for every school, if you have the different teachers for different subjects like arts, music, and sports, then again, it is not affordable one. So we have to go for the school complexes so that we can share the different aspects like the infrastructure, then digital platforms, then teachers, that is the manpower, and they also can learn the different skills from the different students. So number of students are there, so they can learn different languages also and different skills from the other students also. Then adequate resources such as library, science lab, computer lab, skill lab, playground, sports equipment facilities that can be common for all. A sense of community is built to overcome the isolation of teachers, students, schools through joint of professional development program, sharing of teaching learning content, joint content development, holding joint activities, and as art and science exhibitions, sports meets, quizzes, debates, fairs, etc. Because nowadays, if you observe the mindset of students, then you can understand the mentality or the thinking of the different students. So SSC students is thinking about that the CBSE students are scholar one. They are superior than ours. And likewise, they can compare the CBSE school students to the IG or ICSE students. And likewise, so there are number of thoughts. So all these thoughts are now merged into this school complexes because this is the one complex where all these activities, all these board examinations, all this curriculum, all this pedagogy, all these teachers are available at a single platform. Then cooperation and supports across schools for the education of children with disabilities. Then improved governance of schooling system by developing all final decisions to principals, teachers, and other stakeholders within each group of schools and treating such a group of schools which ranging from different to different schools. So all the authorities and responsibilities are given to that respective principals and other school teachers. Eighth point is related to the standard setting and accreditation for the school educations. So whatever the standards, whatever the skills we have discussed in the school education, so all the standard or the common standard should be set for this schooling education. Some accreditation procedure should be there at the school education, because in the professional colleges, the accreditation procedure is already there. That is called as NBA, National Board of Accreditation, or NAC, NAACC. For the school education, so accreditation should be there and some standards should be there. So there are asymmetry between the regulatory approach to the public and private schools. Even though goals of the both types of schools should be the same, and to provide the high quality education, that is the common goal. That is why we should not have the different approaches for different schools, that is for public and private schools. So for that purpose, this 8 point is incorporated, and essential quality standards are incorporated to have the high quality standards. So for that purpose, SSSA, that is one of the committee, that state school standard authority, and which optimize or which gives us or monitor the different aspects like safety, security, basic infrastructure, number of teachers across the subjects and grades, then financial probity and sound process of governance, etc. So all the parameters are going to monitor by this SSSA committee. Then SCERT and NCERT is going to take care about the academic standards. So these standards are the previous one, and now the academic standards are taken care by the SCERT or NCERT, right? So SCERT will develop SQAAF, that is called as School Quality Assessment and Accreditation Framework. So there is a framework which is going to design by the SCERT for accreditation purpose, for the quality assessment purpose. And that is why this 8 point is included. And after the monitoring, multiple sources of feedback should be there, multiple assessments should be there, and ensure the view of performance. We must have the good performance. For that purpose, what are the improvement area in that school educations? So all these standards, all these accreditation processes, and all these committees, all these authorities are involved under this point. So these are the committees: SSSA, SCERT, SQAAF, and last one is NAS, that is National Achievement Survey. So that is specially focused on the health checkup only, because nowadays in the current policy, health checkup is not focused, but now it is a mandatory condition, and that body or that system is there, and with the help of this survey, that is National Achievement Survey, we can go for the health checkup of the school students. So up till now, whatever we have discussed, that is called as part one, that is school education, and these are the different challenges to incorporate to execute these school educations, that is capacity building of teachers, capacity building of test item developers, parental participation and supports, build systems readiness to bring the desired changes.